Welcome. For this first episode, I wanted to answer an impossible question. No, not who came first, the chicken or the egg. My answer to that question is the dinosaurs, who laid eggs way before chickens ever existed. Instead, the question is, how do you roll? Over or under? The debate on the proper orientation of the toilet roll has puzzled the human brain for decades. Is there actually a correct way to hang the humble toilet roll? The answer is complicated, but yes. However, I won't reveal it just yet, because I know, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that no one will stick around for the rest of the video. And if no one watches, YouTube will not play any ads, and I will not make any money. So, for the love of God, please subscribe. There are two main possible orientations for the toilet roll, unless you're a weirdo who doesn't use a toilet roll holder and prefers to keep his toilet paper on the floor, or the bathtub to that matter. Over or under? The toilet roll, or the loo roll, if you're British, tell me about it, has been around for centuries. Most believe it's made its first appearance in China in the 6th century AD, although it was not mass-produced until the 14th century to be exact. The modern, commercial toilet roll was introduced in the 19th century, and this is how we know the answer to this century-long debate. Since then, the toilet paper has become a household necessity, mainly in Western countries. So, it is safe to say that half the world doesn't really care about how you place your toilet roll. If you are Muslim or Indian, you most likely use water and soap for your personal hygiene and believe that the rest of us are strange and disgusting. Or, if you want to sound posh, or you come from Southern Europe, South America, or you are Finnish, who would have thought? Then you might prefer using a bidet. And do you know who else doesn't care about your stupid debate? Hippies. And babies. Yes, I said it, babies. We all know that babies are not human and they demand to be cleaned with wet wipes and water. If you don't obey, they get rashes and stay up all night crying. And no one wants that. Hippies, on the other hand, apparently still use leaves or branches to save trees. This might sound crazy, but in a sense, they are kind of right. Time for some math. One tree produces about 200 rolls of toilet paper. Each day, 83 million rolls are produced, which means that nearly 27,000 trees are consumed daily for the global toilet paper production. I know that's a lot of trees, and I know that the math don't add up, but you need to take into account that a lot of recycled paper is also used in the manufacturing process. However, because of some crazy guy who ate a bat soup, if you believe in conspiracy theories, and a deadly virus that tried to take over the world, we still managed to run out of toilet rolls a few months ago. So, back to our original question. How do you roll? Over or under? Some researchers say that the answer to this controversial topic is correlated to age, sex, socioeconomic status, and political beliefs. Up to 73% of us prefer over, depending on the study you read. Over reduces the risk of accidentally touching the wall or potentially transferring germs. And believe me, no one wants to get any germs by using the restroom in an English pub. That's why men decided that they shouldn't use any toilet paper or wash their hands altogether. Genius! Over also makes it easier to locate and grasp the loose end, apparently. On the other hand, under reduces the risk of a toddler or a pet like a dog or a cat unrolling the toilet paper. Toddlers are being toddlers and they are just doing it because they are still aliens and want to make our life miserable, at least until they are old enough to play video games or buy alcohol. Dogs are just hyperactive and, let's face it, kinda dumb, but no one gets angry with them because they are so damn cute. Cats, on the other hand, are just being mean. Also, under may reduce accidental unrolling during driving in a recreational vehicle or a caravan, as the Brits would say. But that's not even a valid argument, because it is an unwritten rule that no one, under any circumstance, is allowed to go in a caravan. For the love of God, people, what's wrong with you? Going back to the beginning, according to the 1891 patent by Seth Wheeler, the right position is over, with the loose end being on the outside. I know I better go flip the roll before the wife gets home. Thanks for watching. As always, take everything you just watched with a pinch of salt. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I shall see you next time.